tonight, NBC News weighing in on controversial remarks made by veteran anchor Tom Brokaw about Hispanics, releasing a statement moments ago saying Tom's comments were inaccurate and inappropriate, and we are glad he apologized. Brian Stelter is out front.
Hispanics should work harder at assimilation. That's one of the things I've been saying for a long time.
Veteran TV journalist Tom Brokaw now trying to walk that back, apologizing for his statements about Latinos not fitting in to American culture. Now, dozens of Latino leaders are demanding more from NBC, saying his comments are part of a legacy of anti-Latino sentiment that is spreading freely in 2019.
A lot of this we don't want to talk about.
Brokaw, speaking on Sunday's Meet the Press, said many Republicans see the growth of Hispanics in the U.S. helping Democrats.
Also, yeah, I hear when I push people a little harder, I don't know whether I want brown grandbabies. I mean, that's also a part of it.
There, with talk of racial animus, he upset some on the right, like Texas Land Commissioner George P. Bush, who tweeted, "I am one of those little brown ones, and I was loved by my grandparents." What Brokaw said next about conflicting cultures stirred even more anger.
They ought not to be just codified in their communities, but make sure that all their kids are learning to speak English and that they feel comfortable in the communities. And that's going to take outreach on both sides, frankly.
What many people heard was an old and unfair stereotype.
We also need to adjust what we think of them as America. You're
PBS correspondent Yamiche Alcindor pushed back on Brokaw.
I grew up in Miami where people speak Spanish, but their kids speak English. Yes. And the idea that we think American can only speak English as if Spanish and other languages wasn't always part of America is in some ways troubling.
The show moved on, but the conversation was just beginning. Brokaw, who covered the civil rights movement, seemed out of touch with America today. Texas Democrat Joaquin Castro called the comments xenophobic and called Brokaw stunningly ignorant of Hispanic culture. When Brokaw first expressed regret, tweeting, "I feel terrible, a part of my comments on Hispanics offended some members of that proud culture," the National Association of Hispanic Journalists called Brokaw's comments inaccurate and slammed him, saying, "It only further demonstrates Brokaw's lack of understanding of what forced assimilation does to communities." The 78-year-old special correspondent continued tweeting, saying, "I am sorry, truly sorry, my comments were offensive to many. The great enduring American tradition of diversity is to be celebrated and cherished." Now, some of Brokaw's colleagues are coming to his defense, Joe Scarborough saying, "Hopefully he will be shown grace." Meantime, an alliance of Latino groups wants NBC to do more to show the changing face of America. A nation of immigrants, of course, a nation where so many people, Aaron, work so hard to overcome huge struggles and obstacles in order to assimilate. It's part of what makes America great. Brokaw didn't seem to get that. Of course, as always, it's about media diversity. Let's hear less from Brokaw about this and more from Hispanics. That, I think, is an option and an opportunity for NBC.
All right. Thank you very much, Brian.